CIA Director John Brennan announced Friday he is ordering sweeping reforms designed to dramatically change the agency, starting at the top. Among the changes, Brennan wants to beef up cybersecurity and fundamentally reorganize the CIA's chain of command. Associated Press intelligence correspondent Ken Dilanian joins me now to explain exactly what is changing and why. So why did the CIA director feel these changes were necessary in the first place?
Well, I'm not sure he's going to be completely leveling with us about that, but I can say that it comes amid the backdrop of a series of intelligence failures where the CIA has not predicted major global developments, whether you want to talk about weapons of mass destruction in Iraq or, the movement of Russian troops into Ukraine or the rapid rise of the Islamic State. So there's a feeling out there that while the CIA has done some things incredibly well since 9/11, there are also some gaps, and the world is changing a lot. So Director Brennan assembled a group of experts and internal people and looked for 3 months intensively at the agency's functions and came up with this plan.
So one of the suggestions was to break down the wall that exists between the analysts and the operators. And to most of us, I didn't realize that there was that wall in the first place.
Right, and that is fundamental. That is the biggest change Brennan is implementing here. And that is fundamental to the agency's character since it was created in 1947. You know that the operators are the people who recruit spies, who run covert operations, and they have their own bosses. They work in their own offices for the most part. And the analysts are different. They're more like college professors. They take the intelligence collected by the operators and they interpret it and they write papers that are presented to the president. Now, there are parts of the CIA where those two are connected now, including the Counterterrorism Center that's been pursuing Al-Qaeda since 9/11. But for the most part, they don't work together. And under this change, they would begin working together in 10 so-called centers, which would sort of either be geographic areas of the world or in some cases subject areas like counterproliferation.
So what was the rationale behind keeping these two teams separate?
Well, there's a school of thought that says analysts are more objective when they are not working closely with the collector because they don't want to have a stake in the intelligence or the operation. They just want to call it as they see it. But others have said, look, we're not seeing very much of a compromise of objectivity in areas where analysts and operators do work together, so we're not so concerned about that problem. But they are very different disciplines. I mean, operators are the ones that go to the farm and get trained in spy tradecraft and surveillance detection and all that. Analysts work in offices, for the most part, I'm generalizing, but interpret the intelligence. Now, since 9/11, though, analysts have been deployed more often to war zones, and there's been kind of a commingling, and this is the ultimate result of that.
And what about this focus on cyber threats? What's he plan to do?
Well, obviously the CIA does a lot of hacking and cyber stuff now, but what he's doing is setting up a directorate, which would be equivalent of the directorate of operations we just talked about and the director of intelligence. This would be a directorate for cyber that would sort of look at cyber and digital disciplines across the agency, and they're trying to up their game in terms of hacking, whether it's, hacking into a passport database to protect an alias or trying to get information about the Islamic State in Syria where they can't go in. So there's a feeling that, they need to sort of get with the times and really enhance their cyber capability, and this is one way to do that.
All right, Ken Dilanian of the Associated Press, thanks so much.
Thanks, Hari.